Good day, children. Sai Ram, and welcome back to a second session of this lesson, that is last phase of freedom struggle. Okay, in the previous lecture we have learned about the Second World War and the Indian National Congress. We have learned about the Quit India movement. Okay, these are the things which we have already learned in our previous lecture. Now let's continue our lesson. Okay, that is last phase of struggle for independence. Nextly, we are going to learn is the Quit India Resolution. Now, what is this Quit India Resolution? The session of Indian National Congress, one of the session of Indian National Congress, was held at Gowalia Tank, okay, which is at Kranti Maidan in Mumbai, okay, on 7th August 1942. Now, the chairman or the president of this session was Maulana Abul Kalam Azad. He became the president of this session. Now, what was going to be decided in this session of Indian National Congress? Okay, the British should leave India was the resolution passed during this session of Indian National Congress. Okay, by the working committee. Actually, the working committee had passed this resolution that the British should leave India forever and ever. Okay, and this working committee at Wardha was to be finally approved in the Mumbai session. Okay, so this decision of the working committee was to be approved in the Mumbai session. At last, on 8th August, the Quit India resolution put forth by Jawaharlal Nehru was passed with a special majority, with a great majority. Okay, everybody supported this. That is, the Quit India resolution was supported by a great majority. And according to this, it was decided to start a nationwide non-violent agitation under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi. Okay, Mahatma Gandhi should be the leader of this agitation, nationwide agitation, which is going to take place. Okay, and that also a non-violent agitation. According to which, Gandhiji said, every one of you should, from this moment onwards, consider yourself a free man or woman and behave like a citizen of free India. These were the words of Mahatma Gandhi. Okay, Gandhiji said that everyone should, from now onwards, you should feel, whether you are a man or a woman, you should feel that you are a citizen of free India. And Gandhiji also said, we shall either be free, okay, we shall either free India or die in the attempt for freeing India. Okay, these were the words of Gandhiji. And the provoking words of Gandhiji was, do or die. Okay, everybody was very much motivated by these words of Gandhiji. When Gandhiji was saying this, do or die, so the people got very much enthusiastic and they started their full force on this resolution. That is the Quit India resolution. Okay, now this non-violent agitation which was going to be started under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi, okay, with the words do or die. Yes, you can see over here, as I had told you about the Kranti Maidan, that as Gowalia Tank, that is in Mumbai. Okay, here you can see the photograph of August Kranti Maidan, this ground we were talking about. Okay, where the Indian National Congress session took place. Okay, and the president was Maulana Abul Kalam Azad. Now, beginning of the people's movement. Let's see how the people reacted to this movement which was started under the leadership of Gandhiji. Now, there a news had spread among the people that many of the Indian National Congress leaders had been arrested. Okay, many of the Indian National Congress leaders had been arrested, because of which the people got very much angry now. So, what did that people do? What did the people do? They started a procession, started taking out procession. The full country looked as if everyone was on the road only. Okay, the full country was looking so very colorful, with everyone on the road taking out processions and all. Even though the Britishers started lathi charge, they even opened fire on them. Okay, open firing on them was done. Then also the people were not at all afraid now. Okay, everyone, whether man or woman, all were facing this situation very, very bravely. Okay, they had taken Gandhiji's word, do or die, very seriously now. Okay, so they were not at all afraid of the lathi charge also, and not afraid of the firing also now. The agitators attacked some places. Okay, the places which showed the injustice of the Britishers, like the places like the jails, the police station, the railway station, all these places were attacked by the agitators. Okay, they forcefully attack over these places like the jails, police station, railway stations. They even tried to take control of the government offices now. So angry the people had become. Okay, even in Maharashtra, the young and the old struggle equally. Whether man or woman, whether young or old, everybody was struggling for the freedom of India now. That also with full determination and boundless courage. Okay, at many places in Maharashtra like Chimur, Ashti, Yavli, Mahad, Gargoti, okay, these were the places in Maharashtra where people were struggling very, very hard with determination and boundless courage, and made this struggle very much immortal in history. Okay, so only you all must be knowing, the Quit India movement is immortal in history. Okay, the Quit India movement of 1942 is immortal in history. Here we will have we will know about individual satyagraha. Now what is this individual satyagraha? As we know, many a time the Indian National Congress put many demands in front of the British, which the Britishers were not ready to accept. So the Indian National Congress decided, instead of doing a mass satyagraha, let's start an individual satyagraha. Okay, wherein each and every person, on their own way, every single person should disobey the law of the Britishers. This is only called as individual satyagraha. Okay, and Acharya Vinoba Bhave was the first satyagrahi. Okay, he was claimed as the first satyagrahi, and afterwards he was followed by nearly 25,000 satyagrahis. Okay, later on the satyagrahis accepted imprisonment of their participation also. The British government was not going to leave this, right? So even they were punished also for that. But they were ready to accept the punishment also. Okay, let's see what is this individual satyagraha. The British government was constantly neglecting the demands. Hence, the Indian National Congress decided to start anti-war propaganda. For this, it was decided that instead of a collective movement, every single person should disobey the laws. This was known as individual satyagraha. Acharya Vinoba Bhave was the first satyagrahi of individual satyagraha. He was followed by nearly 25,000 satyagrahis who accepted imprisonment for their participation. So I hope, children, you will have understood what is individual satyagraha. Now let's learn about underground movement. Slowly, after the leaders, this movement was going into the hands of the young activists now. Okay, at almost the end of 1942. Okay, the leadership of this movement slowly it was going into the hands of the young activists, young people. Okay. Then there were many people like Jai Prakash Narayan, Dr. Ram Manohar Lohia, Chotu Bhai Puranik, Achyutrao Patwardhan, Aruna Asaf Ali, Yusuf Meher Ali, Suchita Kriplani, S.M. Joshi, Shirubhau Limaye, N.G. Gore, Yashwantrao Chavan, Vasandada Patil, Maganlal Bagdi, Usha Mehta, okay, and such other leaders were also in the forefront of this movement which was taking place. Now, what was the work of these people? What these people had done? These activists, they started disrupting transport and communication. Okay, they started disrupting the transport system and the communication system, okay, which was a government machinery to administer in India. Okay, so they started disrupting transport and communication as well as the government machinery by causing the breakdown of the railway routes, cutting down of telephone lines, blowing up bridges, okay, such type of activities they started doing for this, for the movement. Okay, so what is the impact of this movement? The impact of this movement was seen all over India. Okay, whatever work this young activist were doing, this impact was seen all over India. If you see, a person called as Hemu Kalani in the Sindh province, what he did? He tried to destroy the railway along with his companions. Okay, he went along with his companions and destroyed the railway which was carrying, okay, which was passing by, carrying many of the British troops and supplies. Okay, British people, that is the British officers, and some of the arms and ammunitions were going in that railway. Okay, that was only destroyed by this Hemu Kalani. Okay, later on what, he was arrested and he was punished and hanged till death. Okay, in this way we can see the impact of this movement was seen all over India. Okay, and this is only called as underground movement. What is the meaning of underground movement, children? Underground movement doesn't mean going under the ground and doing this movement. No. Staying in a hiding place without coming into the notice of the government, okay, doing such type of activities, okay, of destroying the Britishers' machinery, okay, that is only called as underground movement. Okay, children, understood what is underground movement? Here you can see a picture of Jayaprakash Narayan and Achyutrao Patwardhan. These were the activists. Here you can see the picture of Aruna Asaf Ali. She was also the activist. Now let's have some inspirational accounts of some brave children. Even the children had taken part in this movement. Okay, what was this? What was this? The school students. Okay, the children were also not behind over here, as I had told you first only. Whether the young or whether the old people or whether women or whether children, everybody had taken part in this movement. So here we are going to find out about some of the school children. Okay, what they did, they carried, they also joined a procession under the leadership of Shirish Kumar. Okay, he was also a student. Under his leadership, many of the students join up holding the tricolor flag and shouting at the slogan Vande Mataram. Okay, and it was very much the because of which the police became very much furious and opened firing on the small children. Okay, in which many of them lost their life, but they were fearless. Okay, so let's read this inspirational accounts of brave children. The school students also contributed in the freedom movement. At Nandurbar, the school children under the leadership of Shirish Kumar carried out procession holding the tricolor flag. The slogan of Vande Mataram was given. The police became furious and opened firing on small children as well. In this firing, Shirish Kumar, Lal Das, Dhansukh Lal, Shashidhar, Ghanshyam, these school children became martyrs. Okay, they lost their life. Okay? Bhai Kotwal's Azad Dasta in Karzat Taluka of modern day Raigad district. General Avari's Lal Sena in Nagpur and such other groups. They made the government so very helpless and witless for months together. Okay, for months together the government was helpless under these people. So many activists and so many people coming up with their own ways. okay, and troubling the government. In Mumbai, Vitthal Jhaveri, Usha Mehta and her companions, okay, what they did, they started a secret transmission center named Azad Radio. Okay, Azad Radio line was started by Usha Mehta and her companions. Now, what was done on this Azad Radio? Under this Azad Radio, patriotic songs were sung. Okay, many of the news were telecasted. Even the speeches were telecasted on this Azad Radio. Okay, such transmission centers also operated at Kolkata, Delhi and Pune for some period of time. For a long period, such transmissions was going on to bring about an awakening among the Indian people to disobey the Britishers and to remove the Britishers out of India. I hope, children, you will have understood till here. Okay, children. So, what have we learned today? We have learned about the inspirational accounts. We have learned about the underground movement. Then we have learned about individual satyagraha. Then we have learned about the beginning of people's movement. Then we have learned about the August Kranti Maidan, wherein the Quit India resolution had taken place. I hope, children, you will have understood till here. The remaining part of the lesson we'll do in the next lecture. Till then, thank you, children.